Hey, I just got to work, I just parked, and I want to get something off my chest. Bill and I have been talking about the Pascack Valley story, which is the school district, like so many school districts in New Jersey, as well as across the country, that are now dealing with restroom use and policy for transgender students and what to do about it. If a boy identifies as a girl, vice versa, which restroom do they use? Which locker room do they use? This has become this national debate. And much has been said about this on both sides. I, on air, have said that I can honestly see the emotions on both sides of this. You've got one group, even though a minority, who feel incredibly uncomfortable. I mean, imagine you being told you have to go into the opposite gender bathroom every day. This is what they're going to feel like, to be in what many are going to say is their gender. They don't feel that it's their gender. And I see both sides of this. I can also see the nervous moms and dads, because this is something that they just, many cases, remotely never even thought about. And how do you make everybody happy? Well, maybe you don't make everybody happy, but what is fair? And Pascack Valley last night, they approved the policy. They already have, for those who wonder, well, how many people does this really affect? They already have two students who are transgender students who have already expressed their discomfort at having to use a restroom or a locker room where they don't feel that they belong. So the new policy is that they can use the rooms for which they identify. This is going to bother a lot of people. And as I said, I've been thinking about this, and you know what I did is I started comparing this to other things. Is it a pure comparison to the civil rights issues? Maybe not, but it's the best I've got. And I started going back and I started looking at some quotes, talking about bathroom use in the Deep South, back when we had whites-only bathrooms. Is it a different thing? Yeah, I get it. I know it's a different thing, but hear me out. Found this old quote, and I have to read this. I couldn't commit this to memory, but this is from arguably the most racist U.S. senator that we ever had, who lived to be a very old age, from South Carolina, Strom Thurmond. And Strom Thurmond did not believe in races mingling, and for many decades was unapologetic about his use of the N-word and his overt racism. And one of the many things he said this, listen to this. An American should be able to choose to work in a place where he is with his own kind of people and not find that at the counters, desks, or benches, they will be forced to work side by side with all types of people of all races. That in the lunchrooms, restrooms, recreation rooms, they will be compelled by law to mingle with persons and races, which all their lives they have by free choice avoided. And so, in the end, I just thought, do I really want to be like Strom Thurmond? And if the person that you're trying to avoid is transgender, do you also not want them in your workplace? Do you not want them in your recreation rooms? And in the end, after thinking about this a lot, I know it may make some of us uncomfortable, but you know what? Just like the Constitution of the United States, and the beauty of it is that it can always evolve and change. Maybe it's time we did too. And having policies for transgender bathrooms for students, it's going to help them a lot more than it's going to hurt us. And I think the Pascack Valley School District did the right thing last night. And like I said, I just got to work. I got to get inside because I got to use the bathroom. And I no longer care who's in there.